things I'm far from perfect, simply redeemed, bought with a purpose, purchased by love. It's not a form of religion, but a gift from above. I am not perfect, no, but I have been redeemed. I am a believer. Do you know what that means? That means I've pledged my life, giving everything. I never knew that this was meant to be. I'm not perfect, but I have been redeemed, redeemed. While I was yet in my transgressions, somebody paid the price for me. I offer up my life to him, and now I say again, I am not perfect, oh, but I have been redeemed. Oh yes, I am your brother. Show you the way. We'll take this road together. Oh, take it day by day. Somehow I know we'll make this journey's end. Make no mistake about it. You have been transgressions, somebody paid to set you free. So offer up your life to him, accept his love, and we'll begin to walk together, for we have been redeemed, redeemed. Life for you and me. So why not give your life to him, accept his love, and then begin to stand together hand in hand. And surely he will heal the land, and we will wear these chains no more, as these walls come crashing to the floor. And then someday he'll come again, and we will find a rest in him. Then we'll be perfect. We will be perfect. We will be perfect. Oh, 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 oh.
We will be perfect.
We will be perfect. Oh, yes, we will. Simply
amen, amen, amen. Welcome everyone to Breakfast with Champions. My name is Zach. I'm one of your hosts, Zach Decker, pastor of South Point Church of God. And who's joining me in co-hosting today is Andrew Finch. We're so glad to be here. So glad to be here. Ain't that right, Andrew?
Yes, yes. And I'm the pastor of Titans University. That's my ministry.
Amen. Amen. Go ahead. Go ahead. Today's topic is meditating on the word till something happens, right? That's what we're focused on. But before we get into going into today's topic, if you know anybody that is needing a word this morning, we want you to go ahead and send your invites, you know, invite them into this place, invite them into this podcast, this time that we have together, and allow them to be able to experience what you get to experience each and every morning with Breakfast with Champions. We definitely want to make that an opportunity for all, including men of the house, more ladies of the house, people that you know, so that they can be a part of what's going on here and what God is doing. I think that it's such an important thing to involve others where you're being blessed. I believe that. So bless others as you're being blessed, and you know God's going to continue that cycle in and around you. Amen?
Amen.
Now, I'm sure you're excited this morning, Andrew, about what we're going to talk about and we'll get into. So if you want to go ahead I guess let's open in prayer. I know that we talk about prayer. Let's open in prayer real quick. Heavenly Father, Lord God, we just thank you so much, Lord. We thank you for your presence. Lord, we need your presence each and every day, Lord. And really, even in meditating and learning more about you, Lord, we need your wisdom and insight. And I just pray, God, that as we open up our hearts to one another, Lord, that we most importantly open up our hearts to you, Lord, so that you would deliver the message that you want delivered, Lord, and that we may be able to experience that together and be encouraged by one another. Lord, we thank you for the opportunities that you give us. We thank you for the positions that you place us in, and we honor you in everything that it is that we do. In Christ's name we pray. Amen.
Amen. Amen. Zach. That was beautiful. That was beautiful. It's always wonderful when I can be in prayer and in fellowship with someone who's very like-minded and like-spirited. And, you know, we come together every week now. And when I tell you, it has truly blessed my life. I'm looking around.
Amen.
And I'm wondering, how the heck did a wretch like me get put in a position to where I could bless others through the Spirit of the Lord and through prayer and through our discussions and our conversations every week, and to be known as the sons of thunder.
Amen. Amen.
But with lightning, we strike and we bring in lightning. It's a beautiful thing. So to get right into it, man, the first thing that came to me this morning is Psalms 91. And it says, those who live in the shelter of the Most High will find rest in the shadow of the Almighty. This I declare about the Lord. He alone is my refuge, my place of safety. He is my God, and I trust him. For he will rescue you from every trap and protect you from deadly disease. He will cover you with his feathers. He will shelter you with his wings. His faithful promises are your armor and protection. And so when speaking on the word until something happens, I couldn't even get past through Psalms 91 and 4 before it really took hold of me that I just need to sit and put the word over my head and just keep repeating and repeating it. And there's a note card I keep with me in my money clip. And I have all the fruits of the Spirit. I have about 30, 40 verses. At the top, it says, living by thy Spirit, Lord. And then in the middle is three sentences. And you can replace man with woman, person, however you want to. But three things I have written on here is, for as a man thinketh in his mind, so is he. A man's life is what his thoughts make of it. A man is what he thinks all day, and to continuously think about something, allowing it to ruminate in your head all day. That's meditation.
Amen.
And so whether your eyes are open or your eyes are closed, mm-hmm. you don't know what's going to happen. But if you stay fixated on the Lord, if you stay focused on the Most High, if you stay looking up at the top of the mountain, not down at the bottom in the valley, and you keep climbing, keep walking, keep moving, and repeating John 16:33, 1 Corinthians 10:31, Matthew 22:14, Psalms 46:10, Colossians 3:23, Philippians 4:4-7, Philippians 4:13, Isaiah 54:17, Luke 6:37-38, Jeremiah 29:11-14, yeah. John 10:9-10-12:6, Proverbs 3:12, Isaiah 1-3, 1 Samuel 10. You just keep repeating these verses as you climb. It's not easy.
Mm-mm.
Not easy. Now, I'm here to tell somebody right now, meditating on the word until something happens is not easy. It's going to be like pushing a boulder by yourself up a hill, up a mountain. It's not easy. And that's something that came to me. It completely threw off everything that I was going to do this morning. I woke up and I got Psalms 91. That's, man, I'm so thankful to be here with you, Zach. Oh, man.
Amen, Andrew. Amen, man. Well, you know, man, I tell you, you're kind of leading me down a different path as well. I mean, just based off of what you've brought to the table with Psalms 91. I mean, there's so much in that, you know, is both comforting and encouraging, because, you know, it's that, you know, waiting under the, you know, under the shadow of the Almighty, you know, and waiting on Him. I think it is relative to meditating on God's word. It is relative to you, you know, waiting until that thing happens, whatever it is God's doing in and around you. I think that's an important way of, you know, engaging in that meditation. And then on top of that, you brought up verses, and one of the verses that stands out to me personally is Jeremiah 29:11. I have this crazy scenario. Well, actually, that's really what God used in my calling overall in ministry when I was young. I was about 19 years old, and there was a youth group that was in shambles. Like they were booming, but the youth pastor was in a situation where he kind of fell off the bandwagon, or, you know, walked away from the faith, whatever you want to call it. Unfortunately, there was a lot of kids that came to that service, and I was just in the place where I was meditating on God. I was meditating on His promises. I was meditating on, I was actually going to a prayer room, with, you know, pretty consistently, and God was speaking to me, but He wasn't moving through me yet, you know? Another minister had come in and had preached to the youth, but it was like, I felt like, I don't know if you've ever been in one of those services where you didn't feel any move and there was no reception. God said, if you don't do what I tell you to do right now, like, because all I'm doing is meditating on God. I'm meditating on His promises. I'm meditating on, Lord, please don't let these kids, I had a burden. Please don't let these kids walk away without hearing Your word, you know, without receiving Your word. They heard something, but they weren't responding. And yeah. And I remember just going, okay, God, I'm going to trust You in this moment. And I went, they opened the room up to prayer, and I went to the center of the room, and I got down on my knees, and all I said was, God, you know, I'm here. Use me. And I remember going into a state of prayer, and I can't explain it other than God. I went into a state of prayer where they were hearing me pray, and they were in, it was in a horse-shaped, you know, style room. So the kids were on my right, going in front of me, and then onto my left. And I'm on my knees in the middle of the room. Lights are dim, and I'm praying. And I said, and the whole time I'm praying about sin and Christ being, you know, he was bit, you know, he was beaten and he was torn, and I'm on the ground and I'm literally lashing at myself, and I'm pounding the ground, and it was a hollow shell of a, you know, it's one of those trailers. So every time I hit the ground, I was like, your sins are destroying your lives. Your sins are destroying your families. Your sins are destroying your relationship with God. And I'm pounding the floor, and it's vibrating throughout the whole container. It's just a big container full of kids. And I'm broken, and I'm bawling. But what was crazy was God took me to a place. I wasn't in that room. I was on a rock.
Hallelujah.
And there was people as far as I could see, and they were dressed in like rags. So it was a different time era. And I'm reaching out, and I can tell I'm preaching. Can't hear myself, but I'm preaching. And then I hear a thunder. Boom. Jeremiah, boom, Jeremiah, boom, Jeremiah. And it was within the same instances that I'm hitting, saying, sin, your sin, your sin. And so I know that that's that was what was reflecting in the natural, but in the spiritual, I was hearing Jeremiah. Never read the book of Jeremiah, never. I get home after that. Several kids had gotten, you know, gave their life to Christ that night. A move. I was, by the end of it, I was hurled in the baby position, you know, fetal position, and just sobbing. Kids were sobbing. I could hear it starting from my right, and then it heard more and more and more and more, and all the way around to my left. And I went back to the word, and I said, I don't know, Jeremiah. And so I told somebody about it, and they brought an old, like, you know how they have those encyclopedias back in the day, like the word. Yeah. And so she brought out this encyclopedia of Jeremiah, and the first thing she opens to is the weeping prophet. I was like, okay. Then I got a letter in the mail, and on the envelope it said Jeremiah 29:11. I don't know how I didn't ever see. I mean, I was going to church regularly. I don't know how I didn't see Jeremiah 29:11, but God blinded me to that verse until that moment. And I was able to open it and read it. And it says, I have plans for you, declares the Lord, plans to prosper you and give you hope, give you a future. And that verse, I know that a lot of people claim that, and it's shareable. The word of God is shareable. Everybody can have that same inspiration. But to me, when you can find a scripture, and this is totally off of what, you know, what I was going with, but praise God, I'll follow his lead, is that when you can find that verse, or you can find that scripture that will follow you all the days of your life, and ensure your position with God, ensure your love from him, you know, his commitment to you. You know, we're not committed to him. I mean, we try. We're not fully. So, I mean, if we were sold out fully, I mean, there we would be unstoppable. But I think that there's things in our flesh that don't fully give in to the full commitment to God, and it would be an awesome thing to see if we would allow that. But I say that to say, you know, find that scripture, meditate on that scripture that God's personally given you, and yes, remind yourself yes daily.
Yes.
His promises are yes and amen.
Yes.
He doesn't move. He doesn't move. He doesn't move. We move. We move from those promises. We move out of that blessing. We move out of the refuge that Psalms 91 says. We move because we don't keep that scripture. We don't honor that in what it is, that it's the word of God. straight to us, straight to our hearts, straight to our souls, straight to our minds, that delivers us. And I think that that's the thing that happens is the deliverance, is the power, is the strengthening, the encouragement, the reminder. You know, God tells me, you know, your name is I remember. Zachary is means God remembers. And, you know, you have to take those things, those little nuggets of inspiration that God gives us, and you have to hold on to them and put them deep down. He says, I put it down into, you know, the depths of my heart. I store it there.
You better speak to him.
I have something. I can go back to that. I can reflect on that. I can meditate on that because I know that his promises are yes and amen.
Oh my God. Amen. Yes. Amen. Yes. Amen. Let's speak on the name. And then I want to read a couple verses from Jeremiah 29, 4 through 14, but let's talk about a name. Andrew means manly, brave, courageous. My middle name, Darnell, means magnificent. So every time my name is spoken, it means magnificent, manly, brave, courageous.
Amen.
There's something in the name, but let's talk about another name. The name of Jesus.
Go ahead.
There's something in the name of Jesus. Just sitting and just saying that name. Knowing where your power, where your strength, where your wisdom, your understanding, your will, there's something in the name of Jesus, the Messiah, the Savior, the one that came to serve all of us when we didn't even deserve no grace and mercy. Just sitting in it. Just sitting in it. Just Jesus, 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 Jesus. Oh, let me catch my breath. Jesus, 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 Jesus. Just sitting in it. Just sitting in it. Something. I'm telling you right now.
Amen.
I'm volunteering y'all right now. Y'all ain't got no. I'm volunteering y'all right now. For 30 seconds. And just repeat Jesus. And watch your phone light up with a text message or a phone call. Before the end of the day, somebody gonna call on you because you're in service of the Lord. When you meditate on Jesus,
go ahead.
On that name, J-E-S-U-S, Jesus, let's talk about it. This is what Lord of Heaven's armies, the God of Israel, says to all the captives he has exiled to Babylon from Jerusalem. Build homes, plant gardens, and eat the food they produce. Marry and have children, then find spouses for them so that you may have many grandchildren. Multiply. Do not dwindle away. And work for the prosperity of the city where I sent you in the exile, where I sent you, where nobody technically is supposed to even really see you. Where no exile, you gone. Do all this in a place where I'm sending you, where you ain't even supposed to get no shine. You ain't even supposed to get no glory. You ain't even supposed to truly be blessed over there. But I'm going to bless you anyways because you went somewhere that you ain't even supposed to be. But obedience better than sacrifice. He said, and work for the peace and prosperity of the city where I sent you into exile. Pray to the Lord for it, for its welfare will determine your welfare. This is what the Lord of Heaven's armies, the God of Israel, says. Do not let your prophets and fortune tellers who are with you in the land of Babylon trick you. Do not listen to their dreams, because they are telling lies in my name. I have not sent them, says the Lord. This is what the Lord says. You will be in Babylon for 70 years, but then I will come and do for you all the good things I have, what'd you say? Promised. I have promised, and I will bring you home again. For I know the plans I have for you, says the Lord. They are plans for good and not for disaster, to give you a future and a hope. In those days when you pray, I will listen if you look for me wholeheartedly.
Amen.
Ain't no lukewarm.
Mm-mm.
Ain't no lukewarm.
Mm-mm.
Let your yes be your yes, your no be your no. Ain't no lukewarm. Mm-mm. Look for me wholeheartedly. Wholeheartedly. You will find me. I will be found by you, says the Lord. I will end your captivity. You will be broken free and restored your fortunes. God wants to give us a wealth and a prosperity and an abundance that we can't even explain, that we can't even imagine.
Amen.
Fortunes. I will gather you out of the nation where I sent you and will bring you home again to your own land. Not nobody else's. I'm going to bring you home to your own land. You're going to have peace in your own land if you sit and pray and meditate on the word and move into that place that God says, man, look, it's not going to be pretty.
Mm-hmm.
But when I restore you,
mm-hmm.
when I restore your fortune, because you sat steadfast under my word, in my word, listening, everything that I'm saying,
mm-hmm.
I'm gonna tell y'all right now, I'm gonna put it straight up. God is saying, shut up, be quiet, and just listen to what I got to say, because you're talking too much. And then when I tell you get up and move, there's only one word you need to move by. Faith. Exactly, Robin. Go sit down somewhere. Exactly. Go sit down somewhere. Miss Marilyn, stay in the place.
Mm-hmm.
Right there. Right there. It may be uncomfortable. Mm-hmm. It may be heavy. It may hurt. You may wonder, when am I going to get this call? Sit in the moment and wait on his word. That's right. When is the phone going to ring for me for my opportunity? When is the phone going to ring for me to save my child?
Yeah.
When is the phone going to ring for me to save my relationship?
Mm-hmm.
When is the phone going to ring for me to save my business, to get that promotion, to get this car fixed?
Man, you just... I'm thinking the whole time you're talking, I'm thinking, man, I'm driving this hoopty that it's so rickety. It's so rickety. Every time it hits a little bump in the road, and you know, it feels like it just vibrates through the neighborhood, you know, and it's like I'm driving down my neighborhood and I'm just like, you know, kind of like hunched down.
Am
like,
I going to make it? Hey,
this is what I got to get me where I need to go. You know, you saying that, just, I was the whole time I'm going, gosh, I'm in exile with this vehicle that I'm driving, Lord, and I don't have the extra funds to be able to do what I need to do to get something that's decent. But he's like, hey, but is it getting you where you need to go? Is it doing what you need it to do?
Come on.
Okay. Betsy, here we go. I'm going to pray for you. Just keep going. Hold it together. Hold it together, Lord. Hold her together. And so, I mean, exile can be anything, but that makes me feel like I'm in exile as I'm driving down the road. I'm just like, you know, people are like, is that even legal on the road? Is that something legal on the road? And you know, and I just, and I, you know, I got frustrated the other day and I said, God, why are you letting me, like, why do I have to deal with this? And he's like, you know, what you have is so much more important. Your gift, your heart, your God. These people that have all these nice and flashy things, he said, that's all they got. He goes, you have peace, you have love, you have joy. You're right with me. I said, Lord, forgive me. Lord, forgive me. Y'all ever been hand slapped by the Lord? You're in the middle of, God, why is this the way that it is? I'm trying to serve you and you're blessing all these other people. And you know what? He said, that's all they got. That's all they got. That's not making them happy. Don't make them happy. People driving in the Lexuses and the Mercedes and their BMWs and their, you know, Ferraris, and they're miserable in so many ways. They're either alone or separated from God or having to do things that they morally and ethically aren't aligned with God. And you know, and he says, Zach, you know what? Settle down. I'm getting you to where you need to go. Be patient. Wait on me. I'll get you what you need. And so I think that a lot of times that we do. I mean, Jeremiah's in the worst circumstances, but God gave him the most authority. I mean, out of the prophets, dude, this boy, he was young and he went straight to the king, straight to him, and didn't hold back. God told him to say something. Jeremiah was there, bold as bold could be. Hey, listen, this is what's going to happen to you. This is what God thinks of you. You lift yourself up above. No. God's going to humble you down. Like, you know, I mean, but he wasn't in the best of circumstances. He was not the desirable prophet. He was a prophet that was consistently in, you know, in exile, in prison, and you know, and, you know, but God moved in him because he was solely focused on him. You know, we got Christ to be solely focused on, like you said, man. I loved how you were, you know, reflecting on the name of Jesus and us, you know, saying that. Man, I've had more. You want to talk about things happening in the spirit, something happening when you're tarrying for God, is you lay hands on somebody and you start just praying the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. I've seen demons manifest. I've seen people laid out in the spirit. I've seen people healed, and it's all by in the name of Jesus, in the name of Jesus, in the name of Jesus. And that will be all that I say. Man, listen, I'm not doing it. In the name of Jesus, in the name of Jesus, they start crumbling. They start falling. Boom. In the name of Jesus. You know, you want to take authority? Speak it in the name of Jesus. And it will come to pass. Something will happen. You want to talk meditation? Meditate on the name of Jesus. Meditate on the scriptures. But you say the name of Jesus and you speak it through him, man, you'll see something happen. Sometimes it might be scary, man. I ain't gonna lie, man. Sometimes it can be scary. You know, shoot. I've seen people like start hunching over and clawing at the floor. I'm like, in the name of Jesus, stepping back. But you know, it's the authority of the name of Jesus. It says every knee shall bow, every tongue confess that Jesus Christ is Lord. Well, demons already know that. You know, you've got a demon that's lingering. You've got a familiar spirit that's attacking your family. Bind it in the name of Jesus. You have authority and power in the name of Jesus.
Man in Jeremiah. Promises of deliverance. Let's go to Jeremiah 34:7. And the first thing it says is, this is the message the Lord gave concerning Israel and Judah. This is what the Lord says. So I'm not speaking on my words. I'm speaking on what the Lord says. I'm speaking on what the message the Lord gave.
Go ahead.
I hear cries of fear. There is terror and no peace. Now, let me ask you a question. So God is saying, I hear you're crying out in fear and terror. But now I'm going to ask you a question. Do men give birth to babies? No? Okay. Then why do they stand there, ashen-faced, hands pressed against their sides like a woman in labor? In all history, there has never been such a time of terror. It will be a time of trouble for my people, Israel. Yet in the end, with an exclamation point, yet in the end, they will be saved. Now, if you know anything about grammar, an exclamation point, usually you end the sentence with a period, like period, boo, that's it. It's done. But when you end a sentence with an exclamation point, there's some excitement behind that. Mm-hmm. There's some, whoa, there's some, oh, you, oh, yet in the end, they will be saved. Like, boom, bam, bang, comic book type stuff. You're going to see all of it just right in your face. Just splat, snap, crackle, pop, like Rice Krispies treats. It's been so good. Yet in the end, they will be saved.
Amen.
God said, cry out to me in fear. Cry out to me in terror. But let's be real. Why do you tarry? Why do you fear? When you know my word is true. When you know if you just stay in my word, stay covered in my word. When we go back to Jeremiah 29, it said, Lord of heaven's armies. So that means you a fighter. So that means if you put on your helmet, that means if you grab the sword, that means if you put on your breastplate and you go to Ephesians 6 and you get the whole armor of God put on you and you put on them boots, you get your shield.
Go ahead.
And you get to swinging your sword and stay covered with that shield and that helmet, let a rock come at you. Nope, that didn't hurt. Mm-hmm. I've been hit harder than that.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, that fell off my shield. God, I got your word.
Mm-hmm.
God, I got faith. God, I'm going to keep stepping on this path of righteousness. And every moment that I step on it, I'm going to keep your word. Let me back up. Hold on. I'm going to keep your word.
Amen.
Close to me. But keep the fruits of the Spirit right here. Right here.
Amen.
Right here. I'm going to keep. It's right there. Wherever I move. I don't need my phone Bible. Mm-mm. I need my book Bible. Mm-hmm. In my backpack.
Amen.
That's like meditating on the word until something happened. Man, oh, Zach, we could do 3, 4, 5 segments of this.
I know, yeah.
Wait, oh, my Lord. Oh, my Lord. This take us down so many roads back. Ooh, we.
Well, I mean, you hitting on the, the armor of God, man. I was taught that. My mother put kind of instilled that in me at a young age was Zach, you're a warrior and you got to learn to put on the armor of God. Wasn't until I was starting to get mentors in my life, which I encourage anybody that's watching this to seek out mentors. You're going to learn so much quicker and so much more through the experience of others. That's called wisdom. Knowledge is gained by your own experiences, but wisdom comes from God and comes from the experiences of others. So if you want wisdom, seek wisdom through mentorship of what you, whatever you see somebody doing that you want to do, start becoming mentors of them, start mimicking them, and then start mastering what they've accomplished.
Yes.
You find the mentor, you mimic the mentor, and then you master what the mentor has taught you. And one of my mentors had taught me that, you know, you need to learn, you need to memorize Ephesians 6, 10 through 20. I missed the 10 on that, but it's 10 through 20. And he said, you know, memorize that scripture. I still have memorized today. I'm not going to say it, but you can read it. But it's so important. And that's one of those verses to meditate on. I mean, I remember as a kid, man, I'd be getting ready for school, you know, and school was not always easy for me. I moved to a small country town when I was, you know, in middle school. Middle school's a bad transition. If anybody's been at that point in life where you're going into where they've already built relationships and they've already, if you walk into a place, and it doesn't matter like school age or even adulthood, you walk into a place that there's already structural, you know, relationships, and there's already, you know, political divides and everything else. And you step into that place and you're new, you know, you are definitely a, you know, a target. And I very much felt that, you know, during that period of my life. And I remember I'd get up and I'll just say, you know, Lord, you know, I put on the whole armor of God. I didn't know the scriptures, but I knew what the armor of God was, the helmet of salvation, the breastplate of righteousness, the feet shod with the preparation of the gospel of peace, your shield of faith, your sword of the spirit, which is the word of God, praying with all prayer and supplication of the spirit. It's about knowing the word so that you can meditate on the word. If you don't know the word, you can't meditate on it, and you can't recognize it for what it is. You got to know the word for you to be able to meditate on the word. If you're just reading a scripture and walking away from it, it's like a man in the mirror. He forgets what he looked like. You have to know what you look like through the word by meditating on the word. And the word tells you who you are, because you walk away from the mirror. In the mirror, you forget that I'm a child of God. I am blessed and I'm highly favored. And then your boss tells you you're nothing. And why you know, you're not performing like you should, or you're telling yourself I'm not doing what I should be doing, or you got the devil in your ear and he's telling you all the lies about yourself and how worthless and ugly and this and that you aren't, you're not enough. And you go back to the mirror and God says, this is who you are. This is who you are. Your word is a mirror of reflection, and you look like Christ. You want to be more like
him, brother.
You're walking in me. You're not walking through you. And if you don't have the word memorized, it's really easy to walk away from a scripture that I felt good about reading that scripture. But then you walk away and you go, what was that scripture? Memorization, you know, within the context of what I'm doing in discipleship and encouraging in discipleship is that they memorize, you know, and holding the kids accountable to memorization. Because I'm like we like to put off that, oh, you know, it's too difficult to memorize. Are you kidding me? We memorize scripts for work. We memorize, you know, we memorize, you know, schoolwork. We memorize rap songs. We memorize, you know, we do all this. You know, my daughter came over here rapping F and do the whole thing. And I'm like, yeah, that's good. Can you quote me a verse? Can you tell me a scripture? And it's if you don't have the knowledge of the word, you can't meditate on the word. And if you can't meditate on the word, you can't manifest from the word, because the manifestation comes from the meditating. Can I get an amen? So we've got to meditate on the word, but we've got to memorize it. If you don't have it memorized, it's really hard for you to, or at least the context of the scripture itself, have the idea and the understanding of what it's telling you. Even as a child, I didn't have the verse Ephesians, you know, 10 through 20, but I did know the concept. And, you know, and for younger children, speaking to you ladies, if you got younger children in the house, they don't have to necessarily know the scriptures at that age, but they need to know the context of that they are warriors, that they are daughters of God. Sweetheart, you are a princess. You know how I know you're a princess? Because you're a child of God. God calls you his. And I'm believing that, I'm proclaiming that in your life, you know, and again, speaking the word of God out, professing the word of God, that's a manifestation of its own. But you've got to know it. It's got to be there before you can speak it with authority. You know, you've got to know that Jesus Christ is Lord before you can speak with his authority. You know, a non-believer can't work in the power of Christ if they don't believe that Christ is who he is. So, of course, they're not saved. They're not, they see him as a historical figure that, you know, did some cool tricks. That's not it. He's God. He's God in the flesh manifestation. And so he's the word of manifestation. Amen. Says he was wrapped in flesh, but I digress, man. But I'm really loving how, you know, God's moving in this segment.
Man, I'm sitting here looking at my note card, and I'm listening to what you're saying, and I usually don't quote scripture a lot to other people. I don't like to come off holier than thou, but I like to guide people to the word of the Lord.
Just do it, man. Just do it.
And Proverbs 16:3 and Proverbs 16:33 came to me. Commit your actions to the Lord.
Mm-hmm.
Will succeed. Proverbs 16:3. Now, if people ain't saying amen to that, Proverbs 16:3, commit your actions to the Lord and your plans will succeed.
Mm-hmm. Amen.
All I'm hearing is, hey, God, this is for you. Your word said I can't fail if I commit it to you. But you got to mean it.
Mm.
You got to mean it. Because
mm-hmm.
God will call out a false prophet.
Mm-hmm.
God will call out a false prophet. You can't just say, I commit these plans to you, God. I'm meditating on this word for you, God. I'm moving in faith for you, God. No. No. God don't work like that. God will strike you down before God will exalt you if you play with his word. Commit your actions to the Lord and your plans will succeed.
Amen.
Proverbs 16:33. Let's add a 3 to that, to the verse. All right. We may throw the dice, but the Lord determines how they fall. You want to play with God? Play with the meditation. All right, here we go. God determines how they fall. So if you really meditating on the word, if you really sitting down, being still, going up on your mountain, going in your office, closing your door, going in your prayer closet, going in your room, going somewhere and getting still, and you really throwing them dice, God gonna make you win every time. Even when it looks like you're falling, you're failing, things aren't happening for you.
Amen.
God is going to qualify the unqualified. God is going to call the ones that aren't supposed to be called. But in order for you to hear the call, just meditate. Mm-hmm. Sit down. Prayer is meditation.
Mm-hmm.
It's what me and Zach are getting at.
Yeah.
2 seconds. 2 seconds. That's God, thank you for it. Was something that you were talking about. You mentioned putting on the armor of God, right?
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Every single night, I said, God, grant me the serenity to accept the things I cannot change, courage to change the things I can't, wisdom to know the difference.
Mm-hmm.
God, give me Philippians 4:13. I can do all things through Christ who strengthens me. Mm-hmm. When my mom was sick in high school, and I thought she was going to die, those were the only two things I said to put myself to sleep that night.
Mm-hmm.
When I was 15 years old, and my God, 18 years later, still got my mom. Stop meditating on that word. Stop meditating on those words. When basketball was almost taken from me, when I almost lost my life, when my top rib was cracked. At the back of my heart, I meditated on those words. My God, 18 years later, here we are. Sons of thunder bringing lightning, raining. It's only on the word. And sometimes something happening is not a major miracle. It's just somebody giving you $5 to get a sub sandwich.
Yeah.
$10 a gas to get you to and from, a free haircut, somebody showing up at the church that you've been inviting 40, 50, 60 times.
It's about how many times it takes.
Man, but they showed up.
Sometimes. Amen. Amen.
That's what meditating on the word brings you.
Mm-hmm.
You ain't always got to look for the big ask. Sometimes it's just that little thing where God shows up. God, can you start my car today?
Mm-hmm.
It's just sitting right there for 5 minutes till it. Sometimes that's all it is. Meditating on the word until something happens, Zach.
Amen.
Man. I don't even know how I've been so blessed to be right here to even have this conversation with you.
Amen.
Every Thursday, man. This is us meditating on the word.
Yeah.
And I kid you not, as soon as we leave, as soon as we close down Zoom, I get a text message or a phone call.
Yeah.
As soon as we leave.
Yeah.
I don't know if that's happening for y'all, like it's happening for that.
Yeah.
But I got a brother in Tyler, thunder, amen, lightning, raining down between Arlington and Tyler.
Amen.
Every single Thursday. And I know it's raining down around the nation.
Mm-mm.
I know it is. Thank you so much, Zach, for even giving me the opportunity to be a co-host with you, man. Oh my gosh. You are so, man. Oh man.
Man, I'm over here blushing, man. I feel the same way though, man. I don't you know, I think that Marilyn, you know, was definitely, you know, she had her separate relationships with both of us and could, you know, can sense that in that relative spirit, you know, that kindred, you know, connection. And I think that, you know, God is using it in a mighty way. And, you know, I'm just appreciative as well, man. I can't wait to get with everybody. You know, we got this weekend coming up. Saturday, if you don't have your tickets, what? You're going to miss out. You're going to miss out, man. There's a lot of good people there. That's all I got to say. There's a lot of good people there. And I'm talking about much, much outside of myself. You know, I mean, there's a lot of good people there. And if you haven't gotten your tickets or you haven't signed up for it yet, man, sign up for it. Like, I mean, like right after this cast, like go and sign up because it's going to be good. It's going to be inviting from what I hear. I'm not going to, you know, spill any beans, but it's going to be very inviting. It's going to be very, interactive. You're going to be able to
interact. Real quick, Zach, Miss Maryland, I know you're listening. If you could drop the thank up,
she already is. Oh, look at it.
There we go. Do your thing, Zach. Keep going. I'm gonna be quiet.
Hey, but I'm just saying, you know, you're gonna be hearing it. You're gonna be seeing posts on Facebook. Like, I should have been there. Yeah, you should have. So get your tickets. You know, like, you know, do that and get connected with us, you know, in ministry altogether. Because I know that this is a blessed ministry. And I know I've been blessed. I know, Andrew, I know you've been blessed. And it's encouraging. And you know, it's really not difficult. You know, I've done ministry, and then I'll shut up. I've done ministry for a while, 7 years before the 3 years that I was in hiatus. But I won't call it a sabbatical. It was a hiatus. It was desert time. There's a desert time for everybody. If you haven't had a desert time, it's coming. It'll come. Just be ready. Don't stay out there too long. All right. Yeah. But be encouraged to get involved in any way that you're given the opportunity. Wait for that door to be open and say yes to it. Say yes to what God's doing and making available. You know, I think sometimes we try to put ourselves in boxes just like we do God sometimes. And it's, you know, get out of your box, because God can't use your gift until you're willing to accept the fact that you have one, number one, and number two, that you, give yourself the freedom to act in it, you know, and believe God. So that's my final thoughts. I'm just excited about, you know, the future of this ministry, the future of what God has for us, the hope in the future. I know there's going to be tough times come around, but man, God gets the glory each and every time. In exile or in acceptance, we are His. We're God's.
Man, with that, you know, I know we got 8 minutes. I'm going to finish with the fruits of the Spirit, and then I'm going to pray out, and we're going to send everybody on their way to have a wonderful, godly day. The fruits of the Spirit, before we pray, we want everyone to go with love, with joy, with peace, forbearance, kindness, goodness, faithfulness, gentleness, and self-control. Those are the fruits of the Spirit, and we want everyone to go and meditate on those. If you don't meditate on anything else, meditate on the fruits of the Spirit. Be full and eat and get the vitamins and the minerals of the fruits of the Spirit: love, joy, peace, forbearance, kindness, goodness, faithfulness, gentleness, and self-control. With that, we will close in prayer. God, we pray that if nothing else, that everyone under the sound of our voices has heard to just meditate on Jesus. Just meditate on the fruits of the Spirit, on love, joy, peace, forbearance, kindness, goodness, faithfulness, gentleness, and self-control. If they don't meditate on anything else, God, we just pray that everyone meditates on the miracle worker, on Jesus, on the one that came to save our lives, you gave us grace and mercy, and we pray that you have everyone at least meditate under J-E-S-U-S, Jesus, our Lord and Savior, the only begotten Son that came down here to be put up on the cross when we fail, when we sin, when we forget to repent, when we fall short of the grace and the mercy and the love that you have for us. God, we ask that you give us the Spirit of the Lord, the fruits of the Spirit, love, joy, peace, forbearance, kindness, goodness, faithfulness, gentleness, and self-control. We pray that as we go out this week and we get ready for the Relationship Summit Part 2 on this weekend on the 29th in Tyler, Texas, we pray that whoever can't be in the room still finds a way into the room, whether it's virtual, whether it's online, however they need to find their way in. We pray that you carry all of us, every one of us that hears the re-recording, that hears the current play right now. We pray that you guide our steps on a righteous path and give us the Philippians 4:13 strength to move on faith, not by sight. Because at times it's going to get hard. But we pray that somebody, even if it's just one, but somebody will take one verse, whatever verse they find, and they walk and talk it all day, every day, until it is memorized, until it is internalized, until they are mesmerized by the miracle workings in their life that you are doing, God. Thank you for the Breakfast of Champions. Thank you for Miss Marilyn. Thank you for my brother Zach and the Sons of Thunder, because we bring in the lightning every Thursday. So show up for the storm, because God is disrupting with all that his word is. It is in Jesus Christ's name we pray. Somebody shout hallelujah and amen. I love you, brother.
Amen.
All of y'all, thank y'all for joining us every Thursday at 6 a.m. We got it Monday through Friday. It's not just me and Zach on Thursdays. It's Monday through Friday. You could get in the room at 5:45, start promptly at 6, and we're done by 7. Come get your word. Come get your Jesus. Come get your God. Monday through Friday. Don't wait till Sunday when you get to church. Don't wait for your Bible study on Tuesday and Wednesday. Come on, get you some church. Come on, get you some God Monday through Friday. We love y'all.
Amen. Hallelujah. Amen. Have a wonderful day.
Yes.